So you don't believe none of that?
What about UFOs? You ever seen a UFO before?
I've never seen it, but hey.
So how do you explain that?
That's
the angels flying around.
They get Isaiah 6:15.
And that's how the Lord coming back to the earth. The Lord's coming back the same way he left. If you read the book of Acts, they tell you the one they call Jesus left the earth. They say he got beamed up. He got received by a cloud, a chariot. And he went up to the sky. And he said he coming back the same way that he left, with legions of angels.
I don't know where the Bible is, but there's too many things wrong with it.
Like what? I mean, there's nothing wrong with the Bible, but there's a lot of things wrong with the churches. The church is teaching. Give me one example.
Adam was not one man.
It wasn't.
Was many.
It was many. Yeah, you're right. The Bible says that. Yeah. I get Genesis 3.
Yeah. I'll tell you. Genesis 9:3. Are you familiar with that verse?
What is it?
Genesis 9:3.
One second. I'm gonna one thing at a time. You said there was more. Adam was a man, right?
Right.
Cause you know in the Bible, like you read the book of Ezekiel, and it says son of man. They call Ezekiel son of man. When you look that word man up, it says Adam. Because Adam is the Hebrew word that means man.
Okay, but what about death?
Yeah, but once that peep
in. What about death? I mean.
Yeah, hold on. Check this out. Okay, here it is. Genesis 5:1. This is the book of the generations of Adam. And the day that God created man, in the likeness of God made he him. Male and female created he them and blessed them and called their name Adam in the day they were created. So it tells you that Adam was a bunch of people. You know what I'm saying?
Look forward to Genesis 9:3, where they preach that drugs are not good, such as marijuana is not good.
Oh, no, you're talking about Genesis 9:3. Says, every moving thing that liveth shall be meat for you, even as the green herb I have given you all things. It says the green herb is for meat. Meat is the word for food.
Meat is the word.
The green herb, but weed's not food, it's a medicine.
It's a nourishment.
It's medicine, it's not food. You don't eat a weed sandwich. You eat a sandwich. You know what I'm saying?
Because
weeds
meat
is a medicine.
Meat, it also states that meat in the Bible is for the nourishment of the soul.
Well, it's food. Meat is food.
So it's for nourishment.
That's why when the Lord said, when you sit down with the meat with somebody, you're breaking bread, you're eating a meal. So when it says the green herb,
you're also nourishing the soul. That's part of it.
Nah,
you got to do.
That's talking about, now you're trying to say it's talking about weed.
It
said the green herb is for food, meaning the apple is on the all the plants got green leaves. Apple is food, oranges is food, cucumbers is food, tomatoes, collard greens. What color is collard greens? Mustard greens.
They're green. But they're not herbs.
They are herbs.
They're not herbs.
Herb means
fruits
plant.
And vegetables. It also speaks upon the fruits and the vegetables also in the Bible.
You got actual herbs too, like lemon balm. You ain't supposed to.
You use it for nourishment though.
Right. It's a medicine.
Which aspirin contains hope. All these medicines contain coke. They're also used to heal you. Coke is not drug until you make it a drug. It was man-made into a drug.
The cocoa leaf is like a stimulant.
It's a medicine.
It's like caffeine.
Yeah.
Crack, that's what it did.
Crack is man-made. You have to add stuff to it.
There's a
The Most High got a purpose for every plant. Every plant got a purpose.
It's man-made because they add other things to it. We
Did you know during slavery, they used to give the slaves the coca leaf to eat?
Yeah.
They used to actually feed the slaves coca leaves.
Yeah.
Yeah, but
have you ever drunk the energy drink?
No, I had one. They never do it again. Yeah. Yeah. I had one. You're not supposed to drink that.
Yeah, I did that one time.
Never do it again. I did it once too, man.
And I was in the house, like I was about to die. I was all jittery.
You ever take an aspirin for your headache?
If I have to.
You done good.
Actually, aspirin actually come from some kind of tree or something, don't it?
What's that?
They come from the aspirin. It all comes from nature, though.
Yeah.
It's a derivative from bark.
But the point is this. Genesis 9 and 3 is not talking about cannabis. It's talking about food.
Right.
Now,
you ain't supposed to be smoking anything just so you can get high. That's not, does that sound like a God that's lawful? That's go on, man. Go on and smoke that so you can get high.
Sniff it, smoke it.
Me, myself, that's how I talk to my God.
That's how you talk when you get high?
That's when I feel... My spirits.
When you get high.
Yeah.
Right. You know, that means you're spiritually discerned.
My mind is correct. My mind is correct when I know the right from wrong. To go out here and stab a man for nothing. That's my conscience.
Yeah, that's common sense.
God is your conscience. It's not one man's belief, because every man can believe something different. As long as you have a conscious belief that teaches you right from wrong, that's what God is.
Let's get back to the point, though. But you said you don't believe in the Bible.
I don't.
But then why would you use the Bible to say it's okay to smoke weed?
Because a lot of people use the Bible as their reference for God. And I use it to show you that God is not just the words. It's something different. It's something different, man. You can't... You got to believe in the higher power because the Quran and the Bible are two different books, but they teach the same thing. So
there's a whole lot of people out here claiming that
the Quran don't teach the same thing as the Bible.
Knowledge and understanding, and have literally none. You know, it's common sense. You're not supposed to. It's common sense you're not supposed to rob somebody. It's common sense you're not supposed to just go stab somebody. Even a fool knows that. But anyway.
Psalms 14:1. The fool has said in his heart, there is no God.
Well, if you don't believe in God, you're a goddamn fool.
No, he said he believed in God, he just don't believe in the Bible.
Well, the Bible is the Most High. Yep. The Bible is the Lord. The Bible is the truth. So if you can't believe the Bible, you don't believe it. You believe in the spiritual Satan. You know? I'm picking choose what I believe in. The Lord loves me, gonna love me. It don't work that way. It don't work that way when you're straddling a fence from doing evil and thinking in your mind you're doing good. It don't work that way. You gotta come in all the way or you out. Period. You're condemned or you're accepted.
So
you know?
What's the difference between a man out here on the street killed someone? It's the same shit.
Because both of them motherfuckers killed somebody in an evil deployment, murdered someone. Because killing is, in some circumstances, killing is a righteous act. For example, like that, like O.J. Simpson, when he killed Nicole, the bitch, his wife, Nicole.
He did a
righteous act killing that adulterous bitch.
Yep.
That was a righteous killing. He didn't murder her. You understand what I'm saying now?
Because
she was an adulteress.
What's her last name?
She was an adulteress. Get the adulteress in scripture.
But they were divorced.
She divorced him.
Right, that divorce is like this.
That's the white man's laws.
That's a society.
This world is in divorce.
They don't go by the scriptures.
Thank you.
I got it right here.
Thank you.
Because in the scriptures tells you that if a woman commits adultery,
you already got it. I got
her husband, she should surely be put to death.
I got it. Leviticus 20.
I'm sorry.
Oh no, you good?
But society would brainwash you and think like, oh, you know.
Yeah, because
that's,
look.
That's a normal thing.
Hey, man, I like the way that you...
Let me read it for you, bro.
I got to go, my brother.
Look, before you go, we're the prophets of the Lord, and we're out here to give you 100% truth. We're not going to give you something that you want to hear. We're giving you the truth and the truth only.
That's what happened to the women in the ancient world, so they can see that. Like, oh, no.
It's an example.
For example.
When a bitch gets stoned to death, like, oh, I ain't committing adultery.
But here in America, the woman is set over you.
And adultery is legal. A woman can break the law of the Bible. She'll commit adultery on you, and then she'll collect child support, EBT, get all kind of goodies for being evil.
Rewards.
Look, Leviticus 20:10. And the man that committeth adultery with another man's wife, even he that committeth adultery with his neighbor's wife, the adulterer and the adulteress,
both of them,
shall surely be put to death.
Who did O.J. Simpson kill? He didn't just kill her.
He got both of them.
He got both of them.
And that was spiritual.
You know? And he got set free. But this devil is a hypocrite. The man was proven innocent in the court, but they went and set him up on some other shit to lock him up. You see what I'm saying? This is world, man. This world is backwards and evil, man. It's deceitful. It's all fucking hell. These people ain't your people.
Nope.
These people ain't your brother, man. They're out to get you, period. You know?
Everybody's your enemy.
This is the first brothers you ever ran into in your whole entire life, and you're probably about 40-something years old. This is the first brothers, true brothers, that you ever ran into in the whole life. All the motherfuckers that's out there trying to be your boy, man, they just waiting for an opportunity. See you with a fine-ass girl, they plucked on that girl. Once you turn your back, man, let me go take a piss, I'll be back. They right there, you in the bathroom, pretty. What's up, girl? You know, that nigga ain't shit. You know,
that nigga
got gonorrhea.
You just know saying what I'm all saying? Kind of shit.
Yeah, just being deceitful as fuck, man. But we out here, we were put out here by the Lord to come out here and give you a message. Give not just you, give the world a message.
Why they killed the ancient prophets? Because they were saying stuff.
Same people.
They weren't there.
Same people.
Why they nailed the Lord on a cross?
Same people, his people.
Because they was hard, they went hard.
His
they
own,
wasn't none of these soft, little, peep sweet.
Feel good message. Feel good message.
Because if you bug the world out and talk about love, you're going to get bugged out out of that.
That's right.
And you're going to love every goddamn thing.
Let me read some Ecclesiastes 7 chapter 4.
Every abominable wicked thing.
I'll take your last words before I get on that bus.
Bus ain't coming yet, bro.
Okay, let me give you this scripture about this. This is Psalms 40:7. Then I said, I come in the volume of the books. It is written of me.
He come in the volume, the whole book. You know?
The Old Testament and the New Testament.
When you come into this world, this is what makes the Most High. He's so bad, man. He sent us in his book. He sent us in his world with the instruction manual. You can't go wrong with the instruction manual, just like the scripture said.
That was passed down to us from our forefathers.
Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. We're the sons of them.
There's a reason we preserve this book. You know what I'm
saying? Y'all be out here all the time.
Yeah. Every Sunday.
Alright, I'll be here.
Where you going?
I got to get on the bus, man. And my daughter waiting.
How far you gotta go, man?
I got to call the refugee in Refugee in jail.
I'll take you home if it's like all that.
For real. That's where I gotta go.
Okay. Where we at, bro?
I just came.
Oh, the Most High got you. And took a turn on you.
There's a reason for that.
Okay, oh, wait.
And these rally TV shows totally discombobulate the minds of the masses.
Discombobulated, right?
Yeah, they don't teach.
Because, like, back to the O.J. Simpson thing, you know, it's like the women already walk around here like they got a protection thing over, like they can do, say whatever they please.
Because they got that
you better not dare say anything to confront them about it.
Yeah, a woman called 911 on you going to jail whether you actually hit her or not.
That's right. They should have to say you did for a
reason. Yep. It's set up like that. That's why if a woman, if you get Section 8 housing, she's not allowed to have a man in there with her. They'll take it from her.
That's right, that's right.
Because how they control your ass is they keep the family divided. You can't even raise your own children in this filthy fucking piece of shit.
And that's one of the main reasons why you got sometimes domestic violence. Because a man knows his heart when a woman's all in his face. You know his spirit, that this woman shouldn't be talking to him like that. Oh. Because in reality, it goes with the Most High, his son, man, then a woman. But like you said, it's all flipped upside down.
Yeah, because a woman, a woman is not supposed to have any rights. You know what I mean? Like, a woman is not supposed to be allowed to walk around free without supervision.
I got it.
You know what I'm saying? I'll go ahead. Because a woman's property.
Here you go, bro. This is 1 Corinthians 11 and 1.
Yep.
11 and 1. See, the Lord didn't start confusion or this, what this called, what this fucking society is referred to as scrambled eggs. You know, scrambled burnt eggs, everything mixed up, you know. This is 1 Corinthians 11 and 1. Be ye followers of me, even as I also am of the anointed. This is Apostle Paul, okay? Now I praise you, brethren. He didn't say, I praise you, everyone. Brethren, that ye remember me in all things and keep the ordinance.
The ordinances.
Order.
Order.
Not out of order. He didn't say keep shit out of order.
Yeah, husband is over the wife. It didn't say for faggots to walk around holding hands, kissing each other.
As I delivered them to you, but I will have you know that the head of every man is Christ, the anointed. I don't like saying Christ. And the head of every woman is the man.
Yep.
Order.
That should be common sense though, right?
Common sense, common sense. And the head of the anointed, our Lord, Yahweh Shai, who the world ignorantly calls Jesus, the head of the anointed is the Most High, Yahweh. You know? But these people are just out of order. This is how they like it. They like being out of order. Just like ancient Babylon. They were completely just gone, man. Completely gone, man. Didn't want to hear anything. Didn't want to be rebuked. Didn't want, you know, get rebuked. Hell, they put the Lord to death for rebuking. They put him on the cross. His own people, like one of the brothers mentioned. They put him on the cross. And that was our people. Our people, the Israelites. So it was like... crucify him, crucify him. They were shouting out. Our people shout, you know. They were shouting.
Right before the crucifixion, they had the opportunity to let him go. They said, we can let one of these prisoners go. We can let the king of Israel go.
Yep.
Or we can let Barabbas, a thief and a murderer and a liar, go.
And that was the devil that knew he did right.
And they chose to let the thief and the demon go.
That's right. And then they said,
crucify him.
That's right, crucify him, crucify him.
And then Pontius Pilate said, what, you want me to crucify your king? And what did the people say? Because we have no king but Caesar.
And that's right, and his blood shall be on us and our children. And that's what they said.
The Most High was like, okay.
And he held them to it. And that's what he's going to, hey man, shit is about to hit the fan. Because like he said, he's holding them to that. Shit is about to hit the fan. So the Lord is coming to slaughter 2/3 of Israel. Y'all seen the nigga on beast on YouTube that making video about 2/3 don't mean 2/3?
I don't want to see
it. It's some stupid shit. He brought all kind of videos and all kind of scripture. They had nothing
to
do
with
it.
Who is it though? You know who it is?
I gotta look on my tablet.
Oh, okay.
Let me get this precept for you. Was talking about the ordinance.
Right.
And this is Proverbs 24 and 21. My son, fear thou the Lord and the king, and meddle not with them that are given to change.
Oh, that's why they be like, oh, this is 2015 times of change. And now women are equal now. Now we gotta accept transgenders in the LGBT community. We gotta accept faggots. We gotta accept pedophiles.
What you think of that? LGBT community. Lesbian. What is it? Lesbian, bisexual, gay, transsexual community.
Yeah.
I kind of say, cool with the facts, because it's more pussy out here for me.
Yeah, but the funny thing is, man, these niggas is fucking the fags and the women. You heard a bisexual? It says LBGT. You know?
That's like your boy Charlie Sheen got, they say
he got AIDS.
He claimed to be straight, but he fucking trannies. He was fucking trannies.
He was fucking everything.
And he giving all these bitches AIDS.
That fucks the pussy up.
And all these bitches got AIDS because of some faggot motherfucker. And that ain't infecting.
It's bad enough these women are fucking everything anyway. And that fucks their pussy up. See, they ain't got the sense enough to know that they can't open their legs to just every and any man. They only supposed to, a woman's pussy, it'll tell you itself that it's with another dick. And she's cheating on you. The pussy is telling you by smelling it. Yeah. You smell it.
And the spirit will tell you too.
Yeah, you smell it. That's right. Yeah, the spirit definitely tells you.
Yeah, you'll know when a bit, because you always got that feeling. There's never a time you didn't have that feeling.
That's right. Man, these women outnumber us too much, man. That you don't need another man's wife.
But she know in the back of her mind, she just fucked so and so.
Because her spiritual vibrations are all whacked out.
Yeah. Fucking with her brain, like, damn, I just fucked so and so the other day.
Mm-hmm. And you wonder why this bitch giving you a hard way to go? That's because she got three other dicks on the side.
Yeah. She got the spirits from them other dicks. You know, them spirits
and
of the dicks.
And that's funny you mentioned that, because I was watching Monsters and Savvy.
Yeah.
About the parasites.
Yeah.
When the bitch went over there to Africa, she caught a parasite.
Oh, shit.
You talking about the BBC documentary?
I don't. It was on, the National Animal Planet.
Okay, I saw. I know what you're talking about.
And the bitch was sleeping.
Hey, these bitches belong on Animal Planet.
And she was, smelling.
And when she was sleeping, she was having nightmares of voices in her head telling her, and I was like, damn, look, those demons are.
Yeah, that's what it is. That's what it is. Because every single man that these women sleep with, they take on the spirit of that man. Imagine a woman that's just out in the club every day, every weekend.
Every week got
sleeping with another man after another man. She takes on a... Imagine if that man is a wicked, evil man.
Because you think about it, that sperm is alive. So when you shoot that nut up in a bitch, it's just swimming around there. Then another nut gets up in there. And then the two different men's sperm start battling with each other.
Mm-hmm.
They came out with scientific studies that said if a woman has more than one man, the sperm causes a chemical imbalance in her brain.
Those are called antigens. You know,
they got real quiet out
here. They're implanted inside the woman's pineal glands. You know, it's implanted permanently inside her glands.
It's like, oh shit.
It's permanently implanted inside her glands. And you wonder why these women are all on psychedelic drugs, you know.
Antidepressants,
you know.
How many of you have a scientific degree?
Do we need one?
What does degree
do
mean? What does a degree mean?
A degree means you're able to talk about.
What does the word degree mean?
So we
why do you have
so
degrees?
Did you get
a degree?
Yes.
So did you wear that little square hat with a tassel?
Yes.
What does that represent?
That I got my education.
That's not what it means. I asked you what it meant. What is the symbolism behind that hat? And why do you wear a square hat? And why do you get degrees? Answer that question, or. STFU.
What does science mean?
What does the word science mean?
I have a question.
She don't know. She don't want to answer because she don't know.
Are you guys Christians?
She don't know.
We're Israelites.
Are you guys Jews?
We're Israelites.
Okay, but you're quoting the...
We're Israelites. You're a troglodyte.
Yeah, that's a female Benny Hill. You ever seen Benny Hill?
If you guys are quoting the Bible, at least like identify with it.
Huh?
We don't want to talk to you.
Yeah.
You're a nobody. Get to step.
You just proved our point. We're right here talking about these wicked bitches, and you hear them. Wicked walking up. Evil walking up.
A goblin queen.
The spirit of Jezebel.
You know?
Yeah, you don't know that.
Exactly.
Come up here.
Don't know shit.
And then you're going to get all mad and amazed, too, when we're rude to you, when you come up rude as hell.
Right.
So, yeah. We got time for that.
You know, these women, they wear pants.
Are you guys conspiracy?
The pussy's not getting no air. Because they're not supposed to be wearing
it. What does the word conspiracy mean?
That's order from the Bible. The women wear a dress so that pussy can breathe. These women that be wearing pants, you take them pants off of them, man, you smell a little funk.
Yep.
That's because the pussy's not breathing. There ain't no air getting up in there. You know what I'm saying?
Disgusting.
Just pussy. Yeah, you disgusting.
That's a fact.
You disgusting.
You disgusting. Look at you.
Your shape is disgusting.
You look like one of the mole men's creatures under.
Dog gonna come over here think she gonna disrespect somebody.
Look like she came out the sewers and shit.
I mean,
look like an overgrown rat that got some mutagen poured on it.
Fucking mama and your daddy should be ashamed of themselves.
Bitch look like some of the Ninja Turtles.
And that is facts.
You know, the Bible is a manly book. Exodus, you know, the Bible, like I said, is for men only. we're supposed to teach our women.
We ain't got we don't respect none of these fools. They come up talking shit, we'll talk 20 times more shit right back at them.
You know what I'm saying? Make you look foolish.
Yeah, we clown on your ass.
See the mentality? Do you have a degree?
What you need a degree? You don't tell me ain't got a degree. You mean you gotta keep your mouth shut?
Because that degree should go back to Freemasonry. That's why they got the square, which goes back to the square, just like the Freemasonry symbol is the square.
I was hip to
you know what I'm saying?
Talking about with the square.
And that's why they wear their priestly robes when they graduate, because that shows that they're a low level priest of Baal.
So what they're doing is giving allegiance to the damn devil.
To the devil.
The whole
they
world,
walk up here like they know shit.
The whole damn world. Allegiance to Satan.
I'll see y'all next Sunday.
That's why they killed the prophets, man.
Because it's truth. You heard the saying, truth hurts. Truth hurts, because truth does hurt. It puts people back in their place, you know? Go on, bro. Go on, read what you got, bro.
First Ezra 4:14. Oh, ye men, is it not the great king, nor the multitude of men, neither is it one that excelleth. Who is it then that ruleth them, or hath the lordship over them? Are they not women?
There you go.
I got a scripture to prove that women are property.
Women, that's how you know everything's out of order and confused, because women are the head of the household. Women are put up front. They're put on a pedestal.
They don't deal with truth. They deal with emotion.
That's right. That's right. That's why none of the 12, the prophets, none of the 82 prophets were women. None of them were.
That's why your girl's whole spirit got fucked up.
Right.
I should have got her on camera, but fuck it. I ain't fucking with this.
Because
you know the people watching, they would love to see the goblin.
The goblin, right.
Goblin.
Halloween goblin.
That bitch looked like one of Saruman's orcs.
Come up here and tell me she gonna be rude to somebody, man. How the fuck you gonna come walk into a tomb? We ain't got degrees. We can't speak on nothing now. Because we ain't got a degree?
The only thing a degree is means your ass is $100,000 in debt. You dumbass motherfucker.
Oh, the fuck
you mean? Oh, you got a degree, now you're a manager at Walmart. Congratulations.
Right.
Fucking losers.
Right. Degrees, and now you're flipping burgers at McDonald's.
No, you're not. You're the manager.
Oh, I'm sorry. That's right. Correction.
You're taking you get longer smoke breaks.
Yeah, yeah.
They're like, what's he doing in the office all the time?
He got a degree.
People should be ashamed of their goddamn selves, man.
People are a fucking joke.
Now, let me tell you something. Ain't no other camp out here would have rebuked that bitch, man. You know?
Oh, hell no.
None of these other camps would have rebuked that bitch,
every
man.
Every single word she said out her mouth, she didn't even know what it was.
She got shut down.
Science degree, don't know what science or degree means.
Don't look me in the window.
They didn't even know what it represented. And trying to come with her. That's how you look. Show you that. They say all the time, if your shoe don't fit, don't put it on.
Yeah, that's right.
Simple as that.
That's right.
Man. Can't say no.
She better, hey, I feel sorry for her. She's an Israelite.
No, that bitch ain't no Israelite.
Yeah, she's
hell no.
Yeah, it don't matter, because the spirit
it
gonna
don't,
fuck
it don't.
Going home anyway.
But you ain't gonna hear me say that bitch was an Israelite.
You know, when that bitch go to her bedroom and lay down her bed, this gonna be on her mind, man.
She going home straight crying. Yep. She gonna eat a box of glazed donuts.
Yep.
The whole 24. The whole 24.
You know what I'm saying? She got a box of gummy bears.
Yeah. You know she gonna fry some pork chops.
Oh yeah.
You know that's coming.
Where we should put this? Is that safe right here?
Gotta feed her appetite, man.
Because if she wasn't that woman,
crusty ass bitch,
she wouldn't have had nothing to say.
Yep.
She probably threw a temple abomination.
Yep. Yeah. The spirit went off on her, man.
Because I'm not even mean like that hardly no more. You know what I mean? I be trying not to be nice to people at first, but you come up just being
like you knew something, like you knew some shit.
Insulting us like that. That was an insult.
That's what it was.
I was insulted.
She was representing all the hoes.
She was representing all the hoes.
Yeah, she was coming to speak up for them.
She got that nigga woman spirit on her at the balls and come up here.
That's like going up swinging on Floyd Mayweather and wondering why he knocked you out.
Right.
Exactly, yeah.
You know what I mean? It's like, surprise.
Exactly. All surprise.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
Exactly. Exactly. Winning the lion's den without nothing.
Yeah.
Nothing to protect yourself.
dumbass.
Stupid ass motherfuckers. You can learn more in the fucking goddamn streets.
Oh yeah,
goddamn
like you said.
College.
Yeah, like you said, it goes going to the. That's like you going to the zoo. Yeah, you just jump in the lion's den and expect nothing
right,
to happen.
Right, expect nothing
that's
to
right.
happen.
That's right.
Taunting the lions too, talking
be
shit
surprised.
To them.
I don't understand why they would do that.
You see, the bitch ain't have shit to say, man. Just shut her up and shut her down quick. You can't, if you don't love this truth, man, and see what it does, man, you in the right spot, man.
I hate that shit. Yeah. How she came over here expecting for us to answer her questions, but when you was answering her questions, fucking crickets.
Right, here you go. This is First Timothy.
Had good five. Questions too, ain't it?
Hey, very good questions.
Well, why do you wear a square, funny looking fucking hat? No, that's his apron for work.
Okay. Here you go, just 1 Timothy 5:13. And whether they learn to be idle, running about from house to house, and not only idle, but tattlers, also in busybodies, speaking things which they ought not.
That's all these women. All they do is out there talking their little gossip. Like, if you got a wife, you better watch her when she's around her friends. Actually, she shouldn't even have no friends.
Yeah, right.
Maybe her cousins.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah, sisters.
Cut them bitches off too.
Because when she's hanging out with her friends, what her friends are that motherfucker, he ain't no good. You need to leave his ass.
Yeah, I saw that nigga on the corner the other day with this bitch.
Yeah.
Lying. He's like, he's making up shit.
You need to leave his broke ass, get with somebody that got some money, got a real job.
Right.
That broke motherfucker.
Yeah, because majority of them black men bitches are miserable, so they try to make them, bring another woman into that same fold. That miserable circle, man.
Yeah, we fuck these bitches, man.
Here you go. I will add, therefore, that the younger woman marry, bear children, got the house, give none occasion to adversary to speak reproachfully. Let me read that again.
Yeah.
Give none occasion to the adversary to speak reproachfully. For some are already turned aside after Satan.
That's what you see too, man. A satanic, demonic spirit is descending upon almost all these fools.
That's right. Here you go. This is 1 Timothy 2:12. But I suffer not a woman to teach, nor to usurp authority over the man, but to be in silence.
In silence. Shut your ass up. Bitch gonna come and quiz us. Bitch, you supposed to...
Fucking surprise.
You ain't supposed to be talking. You know what I'm saying?
Right. You would have thought the way that bitch looked, man. She would have been too ashamed to walk up like that, man.
She was proud. She knew she had us.
Yeah. What did she say? She had a degree, right?
She said she had a degree.
Science.
Down here proud as fuck.
I don't know what none of that shit means.
Yep. Down here proud as fuck. She would go home and study them words, too.
She'd be looking shit up. Her spirit's fucked up for the rest of her life.
The rest of her life. That's right.
She ain't never coming back from that one.
Hell no. It's not possible. It's literally not. For Adam was first formed, then Eve, and Adam was not deceived, but the woman being deceived was in transgression.
Hey, I was just thinking too, it's been a minute since we got on these hoes.
Yeah.
Think about it, it really has.
Yeah.
It's been a minute.
Yeah.
It's long overdue. You know
I must agree. I must agree.
I got scripture. This is Ecclesiasticus 3:9. For the blessing of the father establishes the house of children, but the curse of the mother rooteth out foundation.
Damn!
Yeah, they just destroy the whole, because the family's the foundation of civilization.
Yeah.
So if you destroy the family, I mean, you just destroyed the whole world.
Yeah.
The whole order of everything.
Yeah. I'm watching like little, because I'm my sister, but she watching little shows and shit. And there's always the mom talking shit to the dad.
In every show.
Yeah, yeah, every show.
The dad that talking shit to the mom, they be like, oh, he's
just wrong. That's in the little kid shows.
He's silly. Yeah. Dad's silly.
And just like in every show you watch is like that. Everybody loves Raymond. And Raymond's a he's a fool. He's a buffoon. His wife she's the one keeping everything together.
Right.
Even in that Family Guy, Peter Griffin's fucking retarded.
Yeah.
Simpsons, that was his name.
Homer. The only show that got it halfway right was Al Bundy. He was like, fuck you, bitch. You ain't getting my money.
He wanted to be away from his wife.
Yeah.
You know, Alexa. He wanted to be with her.
Yeah.
That was it.
Yeah.
And that was every once in a while.
And he complained about it.
Hell, she was in her right spirit too.
And even clowned on his neighbor, bitch, said she looked like
Hey, Dyke. Peggy Bundy was a straight nigga, man.
Oh, she she an Israelite, big ass.
Who? Who?
Walking like
Peggy.
Yeah.
You know she a Jake. Everybody on that show is at least that whole family.
Yeah, the whole family was.
Yeah.
I got that Christine Applegate or whatever.
Yeah, Christine Applegate.
She was bad as hell when she was younger, man. She ain't as bad no more, man.
Yeah, she, drugs.
Al Bundy used to fuck her, man.
I remember he was turning that ass.
I remember reading about it, yep.
Oh, for real?
Mm-hmm. He was waxing that ass.
Oh,
I remember reading about it, man. They was in a relationship.
They say Al Bundy, he's a...
what's his real name?
He's a black belt jiu-jitsu. Paul O'Neill. Ed O'Neill.
Ed O'Neill. Yeah, that's all right, I got another scripture here. This is Ecclesiasticus 25 and 19. All wickedness is but little to the wickedness of a woman.
Well, I was just about to read that.
Wow.
Like I was talking about the foundation of the family structure, the woman to break it apart, tear it apart. Oh, what she has done.
And there's nothing you can do about it.
Ain't nothing you can do but complain.
Yeah, that's all you can do.
That's all you can complain to the Most High. Cry out. That's it.
That's what he wants you to do, too.
Can hear our prayers.
Because in a righteous society, a woman can't just leave a man. You have to give her permission to go.
Exactly.
And the king, like back in the ancient world, in our kingdom, even back in the Dark Ages, so-called Dark Ages, back when the king was ruling Europe, a woman, you was together for life.
That's right.
If a woman left somebody, she was called a whore, a harlot.
Yeah, yeah.
She would, the town would shun her. She would get shunned.
It was hard for her to find a man that relate to her.
Because then he would get shunned.
Yep, yep.
They would all look down upon him.
You know, it's funny, there's a commercial, a black and white, I think it's the Geico commercial, where it's in black and white, and the bitch up there running her mouth, and dude was like, where's your husband?
Wow.
You remember that?
Yeah, that's what
was sweet. Yeah, that commercial was sweet.
I gotta get that.
It was I think it was Geico.
They all on YouTube. They put commercials on YouTube.
And it's in black and white, and, right. And they got the bitch came on stage running her mouth and all that, and soon as the commercial went off, he looking around like, where's your husband?
Right.
Hey,
I was watching this Western movie a few days ago with, I think it was Kurt Russell. One of the bitches in the bed, they had a chastity belt on the bed, bitch, man. And the motherfucker was in control of her, hoeing her out. Actually, he wasn't hoeing her out. He just wanted to see her sleep with one guy, so the dude came in the room and she was laying fine ass bitch, too.
That's still fucked up.
They on the bed with a chastity belt on, made of metal, you know?
Damn.
Hell yeah, them panties weren't coming off of shit, man. Shit.
Yeah, because it's shit. You know what I mean? A lot of kings,
and chastity belt's real.
Yeah, sure is.
They went off the war or something like that. Yeah, because they show you they couldn't trust those bitches for him to do that.
I mean, that's just the nature of a woman. I mean, you go back all the way to the Garden of Eden, it was the woman who took the fruit from the serpent, because the serpent goes to the woman.
That's right.
Yeah.
I mean, that's why the scripture said right there, you should get it, that you got to watch over with a putting eye. What's that?
That's it.
You know what that said, man. Right there. Jose, you just had it, 25.
Ecclesiasticus?
Yes, it's 25.
Or 26. 26 or something.
Yeah, because they just...
It says she'll sit by every...
It looks just like
every fountain.
Yeah.
Open her quiver to every arrow.
It's like right here.
Open her quiver.
Yeah, you gotta be.
Open her quiver to every arrow. I got it.
Oh, yeah.
26 and 8. Start at 8.
Yep.
You got it?
I was going to start from 7, but
that's
yeah,
good.
Start, yeah.
Okay.
That's good. 7's even better.
Ecclesiasticus 26 and 7. An evil wife is a yoke shaken to and fro. He that hath hold of her is as though he held a scorpion.
Because what's a yoke? That's something you put around a slave's neck. That's why they have an old blues song talking about my ball and chain. They refer to a woman as a wicked woman as a ball and chain. Something you wear when you're in prison. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead.
A drunken woman and a gadder abroad causeth great anger.
And all these bitches, they a bunch of alcoholics and drug addicts too, ain't they? Running their mouth. And the more they drink and get high, the more shit they talk. Especially the Israelite woman. She's out of her goddamn mind.
That's right.
Bitch talking about she going ham.
bitch, right. Bitch would get up in your face, push you.
Hey, just like that Ronda Rousey bitch, man. Oh, she was really buying into that shit she can beat Floyd Mayweather. Well, yeah, she was really buying into that shit, man.
She really was.
That's crazy as fuck, man.
I wish she would fight.
Oh, that would have been beautiful. He could have killed her.
Yeah, he would have killed her. And then he would have got charged.
Yeah,
then he would have got charged.
Yeah.
He sure would have.
And good for him. Wicked ass nigga.
Yeah, he was wicked as hell.
I see him all the time throwing up the
shit. Oh, but you see why everybody hates Floyd Mayweather? Because they say, oh, he beat up his girl.
Yeah.
That's why everybody hates it. Because she was a goddamn hoe.
Hell yeah.
But hell yeah, he beat
the
shit out of
his. That's the only time I like hearing about Floyd, man, was when that shit happened. That's the only time I like it.
That's what I'm saying. That's nature taking its course.
Yeah. You can't hold your nature in, man. If you do, I mean, something wrong with you, man. You know? It's going to come out eventually. Yeah, it's just going to come out. It's your nature. Bitch, get out of line. You're going to want to smack that bitch, man.
That's what I'm saying. Because, you know. Yeah, like men's nature. Because
you don't want to smack a bitch.
You don't
want
to.
You don't want to.
You don't
want to. But what are you supposed to do?
Like talking shit to you constantly, provoking, just constantly, wearing on your
and
spirit.
Like they're the only ones that can do that. Like, they're the only ones that can do that.
There you go. Oh, fuck.
See, that's just.
Because two men arguing, they're not going to argue for long. They're going to eventually engage in battle.
That's right.
So you mean tell me that the woman's the only one that could get away with that?
I've been saying it. We live in madness out here. That's why now they, like you talking about battle. Now they're trying to force Marines into the infantry. And when the Marines keep saying you can't do it, and they keep failing on the infantry training.
They let them in anyway.
And they still, they push, they keep lowering the requirements or the, what's the word? Lowering, because you know, they have a certain physical requirements. You got me. You got to be able to do so many pull-ups. You got to be able to
run.
You know, do all this and that. And the women can't do it.
Right. Yeah. Hell no.
But they keep lowering the fucking requirements, and the women still can't pass it.
Yeah.
Like that fire shit. When a woman go to try to be a, I can't even say fireman.
Yeah, that's madness.
But, they can't. They don't got a climber rope with the equipment.
But they gonna save you though.
In real combat, they're gonna depend on a man.
Exactly.
You know, they're gonna depend on a man, just like they do in society. Really, they depend on a man some way, one way or another, through child support.
I used to be an electrician.
Right.
And that's some rough shit. You got these big ass drills. You got to drill holes with. And
right.
You
see me doing that shit.
Hell yeah.
I
used to rough houses and shit. Right.
Right.
But
never see me.
I thought it was fun though.
That's not for everybody.
I have fun doing it.
I mean, you pulled your tooth with a fucking pliers.
that's
my dog.
Now, I have all the different trades. I think electric's actually the easy one of the
like
easiest.
That, though, I was running through that shit, but damn. So.
You still got the abscess too.
I got that shit pulled.
No, but look, because there's none but men to work there because women can't handle it, right?
Right.
There was one woman who actually did work with us. We had to go behind her fixing everything, helping her out. She can't lift this. She can't do that.
They can't tighten shit as much as a man.
I mean,
take my shit to the shop and get a bitch under my shit.
But if they would have fired her, they'd have been the discrimination.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Right.
Fucking think women are tough because they get pregnant.
And women do have a high threshold for pain, though.
But the reason why they in pain is not a good reason. This is Genesis 13, 3:16. And to the woman he said, I would greatly multiply thy sorrow and thy conception.
But he did just that.
In sorrow thou shalt bring forth children. So they trying to freaking praise the woman for being cursed pretty much.
For being cursed.
Right. Sorrow.
Because that's a curse, having pain like in those periods.
Because women used to just drop them out. They used to just drop out with no pain at all, you know?
They had the right oils.
Sitting down, too.
Like
they squatted.
They squatted like
we went out and lay down.
But they squatted, right. Squatted. So gravity brings it out instead of them laying on the table and push. Shitting. And listen, I've seen it happen.
Oh, yeah, shitting women on themselves.
Shitting while having a baby.
Yeah, wipe the shit off the baby.
It happens all the time, man. It happens all the time. Actually, it probably happens 100% of the time.
That woman shits.
You know?
Liquid shit, too.
And then they go and get an epithoral.
That big-ass needle.
Yeah, stuck in their back, get the meds, high-powered meds, and they still feel the pain. It still, because a bitch told me that she did her first kid without it, and then she did it if you got the epidural of her second child, and it was no fucking difference. No difference in pain. But the bitch was just high, and the doctor saying, bitch, push, she's not responding, because she high.
Yeah, she
you
high
know?
Her fucking mind.
You know? Stupid ass. Man, this is an evil ass hospital, some evil ass places, man. But that's how the women want it.
Well, we always talk that's about when the doctors become a doctor, they take the Hippocratic Oath. Yep. I mean, the symbol of medicine is the Caduceus.
You talking about the serpent?
Yeah, it's the symbol of Hermes. It's an actual fucking symbol from goddamn Hermes.
Right in plain sight.
Right in plain sight, right.
Right there, two snakes going up the pole with the wings. That's some straight up devil worship and shit. And there's no ifs, ands, or buts about it.
Yep.
So,
plain sight.
Why would you use that symbol if God doesn't exist and there's no shit like that doesn't happen? Then why do all these doctors have a mythological symbol?
Exactly. If none of that exists,
because it tells you
what higher power is they so lead us to. Yeah, those are a few of them.
They go by every on Sunday. I don't know. They go by every 15 minutes. Yeah, but just like on that movie,
what's it about?
Eyes Wide Open or Eyes Wide Shut. Eyes Wide Shut with Tom Cruise. They show you how the doctors were secretly devil worshiping.
Yeah. There was all at that party wearing that Zorro mask.
Here. Gotta have some tissues, man.
I know that's what I hate about this cold shit. You don't feel your nose running.
I just do snot rockets. I don't give a fuck.
I know, yeah. I hate wiping my nose with cold ass hands. You can't feel it, like.
Hey, it ain't cold yet. Wait till it gets real cold. My beard starts freezing.
Yeah.
I get icicles on my beard.
Yeah.
You have ice up on my beard.
Yeah, it definitely gets cold. That's for sure.
This might not be a bad winter, though.
I don't know, man. The Farmer's Almanac said it's supposed to be twice as bad as last year.
Yeah, but that's funny.
That shit's never right. Really? But that Farmer's Almanac, that's pretty much like some witchcraft or something.
It was off last year.
Yeah.
It was off last year.
And when it is right, like they say, what's that old saying? A broken clock is right twice a day.
Yeah, right. So true. Here you go. This is Ecclesiastes 7:26. And I find more bitter than death the woman whose heart is snares and nets and her hands as bands. Whoso pleases the Most High shall escape from her.
Talking about these wicked ass hoes.
But the sinner shall be taken by her.
No, he said bitter than death.
Yeah, because I don't want to be with no wicked ass hoe. If I ain't going to have sex with a loudmouth, crazy ass bitch. You know what I'm saying? Oh. I don't care how good she looks. I just let it go.
Yeah.
I'll find something else. There's plenty more out there.
Yeah, definitely not worth the headache.
Nah, it is not worth it.
You better off just go and buy him some piece of
Yeah, you better get a prostitute.
Because that bitch, she ain't gonna talk shit. She gonna lay there and you want her to moan. It's like you got your remote control, bitch. Moan.
Yeah, sit her on her
way. Don't say shit. Yeah, right.
That's it.
If you are, man, you better off buying some pussy. You know?
That's true.
You better off.
I ain't paying for no pussy, though.
No.
I mean, if you want to deal with a woman nowadays, you're paying for it regardless. You got to buy them, you got to buy some.
Like I said, I don't pay for nothing. I'll go for 2 years.
You got to breed them in.
Trust me, I'm not paying for nothing. I ain't paying for
shit. I'm so accustomed to it, man. I don't even notice it no more, man.
I ain't paying for
it. Because I like being social and polite and kind. And, you know, it's like a way of, it's a way of putting that bitch to sleep, you know.
Yeah.
That's what she wants. She wants you.
She want to be lied to.
She want to be lied to, man. Yeah. So I just play along with
it. Oh yeah, I lie to a bitch
you
all
know?
Day.
All day long, man.
All
so
day.
Here, bitch, drink some of this.
Actually, I don't hardly tell her nothing is true.
You know what I'm saying?
Hell no.
Yeah, these bitches don't want.
After you done beat
her
up a few times, then you give them a little something.
Yeah, you got guys, as soon as they meet a girl, they trying to teach her the Bible. Like, hey, baby, you know you an Israelite. And, you know.
Here's her Hebrew name.
Yeah, they gave her a Hebrew name. Man. Yeah, that's the last time she ever talked to your ass.
Right,
you know what I'm saying? She's like, motherfucker's crazy.
Right. Behold, this have I found, said the preacher, counting one by one to find out the account, which yet my soul seeketh, but I find not. One man among a thousand have I found, but a woman among all those have I not found.
Yeah, so one, so like out of a thousand men, you find one righteous. But out of those, you won't find a single righteous woman. Like, what's that one? Get that Proverbs 31, or 30 and 10. Is that 31 or 10 or 30 and 10? One of the two. I think it's 30, 31 and 10 maybe.
The snout or?
Yeah, about virtuous woman or something.
Oh yeah. I got that.
Where is that at?
It's something 31 and 10. Try
you sure?
That. Yeah. Isn't 30 or 31? I'm pretty sure. Oh,
30.
Maybe I'm going off.
Yeah, 30, I think. Hold up, hold up.
I can get it.
Let's wipe your mouth.
You actually put my tissues?
Hell yeah. Hold on.
That's...
You might be right, though.
I thought it wasn't 30.
I got Proverbs 5.
Bring it out.
Let me see.
I know the narrow.
Did you see anything in it?
I found the picture of a whore's a deep.
It's a little tricky. Fuck it. I try to get it straight. I can't get it straight.
I'm
going to
find this picture because I want it now.
Here, I fucks with it.
I want it now.
It's in 31. I'm telling you, it's in 31 and something.
I got. Let me bring this out.
Bring it on.
Proverbs 5 and 1. My son, attend unto my wisdom and how thy ear. And bow thy ear to my understanding, that thou mayest regard discretion, and that thy lips may keep knowledge. For the lips of a strange woman drop as a honeycomb, and her mouth is smoother than oil.
That's right.
But her end is bitter as wormwood.
That's right.
Yeah, wormwood, that's poison. You drink some wormwood shit, your ass is, you going to sleep and you ain't waking up.
Sharp as a two-edged sword. Her feet go down to death. Her steps take hold on hell.
Hey, you know they got some kind of wormwood drink you can drink, some liquor from wormwood. But if you don't make it right, if you don't distill it right, it will kill you.
Shit.
Yeah, wormwood is like, you look up, it's a certain type of, yeah. Look it up on, you can look up on Wikipedia, but it's poisonous. Yeah, because these hoes, they're poisonous, man.
Lest thou shouldest ponder the path of life, her ways are movable, that thou canst not know them. Hear me now, therefore, O ye children, and depart not from the words of my mouth. Remove thy way far from her.
11:22.
And come not nigh the door of her house.
What you talking about?
The one
I got it. It's right here.
Okay, let me show you.
Proverbs 31 and 10.
All right,
hold on.
Because I'm bringing this one. I'm also bringing it out too.
Yeah, bring it out. We can get them all today.
Let me finish this one. Proverbs 5 and 11. And thou mourn at the last when thy flesh and thy body are consumed.
Yep.
And say, how have I hated instruction, and my heart despised reproof. These bitches hate instruction. You could be sitting there talking to a woman, you know, tell her in a positive way on correcting her.
Mm-hmm.
And just because you say something that's like correcting her,
she can't ever be wrong.
Yeah.
Exactly.
It's
like,
her spirit. Yeah.
What's that saying that? If you don't got nothing nice to say, don't say it at all.
Tell that
to these bitches. They don't got nothing nice to say.
You know what I'm saying? Now,
being correct.
That's pretty much saying that I'm entitled to say nothing. Like, you could be adulterous hoe, do all type of wickedness, but I'm still supposed to say positive things.
Right, yes. Right. You ain't got a degree anyway.
Yeah,
so
she's your queen.
You know what I mean?
She's your queen. She's Mother Earth. She's Gaia. She's fucking...
Yeah, these bitches definitely got a man spirit on them, right? Like,
they do. Yeah. Everything's upside down.
Tranny spirit.
Yeah, they got the spirit of a fucking tranny.
Yeah.
They got the spirit of Michelle Obama.
There you go. Hell yeah, they do.
I'm going to read my Bible first.
I'll go ahead.
Okay, this is Proverbs 11, and I'm going to start at 22. As a jewel of gold and a swine's snout, so is a fair woman which is without discretion. You know?
Yeah, because it's like pretty much it's the same thing as taking a pile of shit, which is disgusting. You gonna put some diamonds in it, like, oh, isn't that beautiful?
Right. Pulled out the shit. Don't even wipe it off or nothing.
Because a swine is an unclean animal. So you trying to dress up something that's unclean with jewelry? Mm-hmm. It ain't happening.
Yeah, they throwing nice clothes and perfume.
Yeah, we're gonna put some diamond earrings in the pig and put some stock, give it some boots.
But all underneath all that beauty is a fucking,
it's a pig. Yeah. And that's all they eat. I mean, that's a parable, but you are what you eat.
You are what you eat.
Almost all these hoes, they eat swine's flesh.
That's right.
All these bitches, they eat bacon, ham, sausage, bratwurst,
pepperoni,
pizza. Yeah. Then they look at
pizza, meat lovers.
They look at you like you're stupid because you don't eat pork.
Yep.
What are you, Muslim?
Right. I had a motherfucking, I told him I want the turkey club without the bacon. He slopped my shit. No, he slopped my shit with mayonnaise, man. Like I fucked up his steaks. I told him don't put pork on my shit.
He did that on purpose.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I was like, damn, like, did this motherfucker just get offended because I don't want pork?
His spirit. That since was, your spirit.
Yep.
So he did that on. He
slopped my shit with mayonnaise.
Yeah.
I went back, got a free fucking meal.
I don't even want. Right. You can't. I don't even want to kiss a girl after I see her eating pork. Mm-hmm. I don't want to touch her.
That shit.
But you get away from me.
That shit come through.
Yeah. You gotta get away. Yeah. You gotta go away. You gotta.
Well, she smell it. You literally smell it coming out of her.
That's a turnoff of all turnoffs.
They do stink.
Because I was dealing with this one woman a while back. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, she was porked up.
Right.
And probably fucking all type of men too.
Oh, my
So, you
Lord.
Know, you be hitting that shit from the back now.
Oh, God.
Come up. And I'm sitting there. My head was like, damn, I'm trying to bust a nut.
I'm out of here.
But my fucking dick was like, that shit was like, nah, I'm not like.
The alarm went off.
Yeah. Like it had a mind of its own. Like, it wouldn't get up. It was like,
the most
nah,
I hit
man.
You with the spiritual salt, Peter.
Yeah. And I couldn't insert.
And that's good,
I
though. Insert. That could have saved your life.
That could have saved my life.
Sure. Yep. You got to make us some that.
And just think about it. What if you have, like, you get a woman pregnant and then your baby's growing up inside her womb? And she's feeding it nothing but swine's flesh in the womb.
Exactly.
And then he comes out the womb nourished on swine.
That's
so he's just cursed from your birth. That was us though when we was born.
That's all of us.
You know what I'm saying?
I still remember my mom making me ham sandwiches and I still remember sitting down as a family, we would all be eating. Pork chop, but pig. Well, my family loved pig feet.
That's nasty.
It'd be a bone. You suck the fat.
Oh, man.
Fat on the bone. It won't be meat on the bone.
You got
fat
in your fucking mind.
I still eat that shit, man.
Yeah, man.
I still remember that shit, man.
You got motherfuckers at Thanksgiving. Everybody laid the fuck out and shit, thinking they ate good.
Got the itis.
Yeah, I was like, man. Now that I look back, knowing I know, I was like, y'all motherfuckers like that because that shit ain't healthy.
That shit is unhealthy, yo.
You're supposed to be, rejuvenated, re-energized when you eat.
Yeah, this food zaps your energy.
Yeah.
It zaps your energy.
Everybody, my mom's boyfriend's friend was invited. He laid down on the couch and shit, knocked the fuck out sleep. My grandma and her rocking chair knocked the fuck out sleep.
Right.
I was the only one I wasn't asleep because I was young, full of youth, you know what I mean? So
I told you my stepdad, he every time he eats pork, he's sitting there for the next day or two, just my stomach hurts. Must have been that bread I ate.
The bread.
Everything but the swine, huh?
Then the next time it happened, like clockwork, must have been in that argument I got in, stressed me out. Maybe it was all that goddamn pork you've been eating.
Yeah, and they stuffed them so hard, too.
They stuffed it.
They don't just eat a moderate amount, just eating a serving's worth of food. These motherfuckers stuffed till they
gorge on that shit.
Yep. And you can't digest that shit either.
Mm-hmm. Nope.
lot of us just shit it right, it just going right out, man. Shit right out. Oh, God.
That shit, you just builds up and builds up. Mm-hmm. Then you get constipated, got just swine's flesh stuck up. Then you're, you can tell when someone's constipated too with that pork. Yeah. Then their face gets all puffy.
Yeah, that's, shit. They get real fucking bloated.
Yeah, you get bloated.
They didn't smell the bathroom after they come out that motherfucker.
Right, yeah, we was cracking jokes on that. Like Thanksgiving, all these little manhole things.
Yeah, the steam coming out.
That's it going to
be
coming right up.
It'd be stinking.
Yeah, it's coming up too.
All that goddamn sewage.
Every Thanksgiving, it stinks outside. Yep. We're not making that up.
Yeah. This is crazy, man. These people ain't trying to hear it, though.
Yeah, that's millions of...
It's Thanksgiving.
Of...
It's a lot to be thankful for. Really?
Yeah, really.
Poop, give me one fucking thing. Shit.
Yeah, they broke every goddamn treaty and shit.
Thankful for Obama. Hey, remember that? Tell them about that shirt we saw a dude wearing. You know, we seen a dude with the Obama coat, right?
Same dude?
No, we saw someone... He had his jacket on, or was it a shirt? I think it was a jacket. But it had the whole family standing in front of the presidential. So it had Obama, Michelle, and the two babies all. It was another one of them Obama coats.
Wow. That's fucking crazy. I seen one of those one day when last time we was out. We was walking up the street.
Yep, this one was even worse.
That's amazing.
It had a picture of the whole family.
Damn.
These niggas gonna commit suicide if he was a legal officer. If he was a legal officer.
He passed all these laws for the next level.
He can be in, something can happen and he can just suspend elections and
that's why
everything,
true.
Man.
I mean, that's true. They can do what they
he's
want.
He's bringing in 10,000 plus more Syrian refugees.
Yeah, sure is.
Most of them are men.
Yeah.
I've seen that too. Ohio is one of the states that's not accepted.
Yeah, but there's cities in Ohio accept it though.
Each city
do their own shit.
But they've been to the east side? Yeah, oh, we was just out on the west
side. North side.
Tom, we was out in the library, me and him last week. We was in that library. It looked like we was in goddamn Saudi Arabia or Baghdad.
Where?
On the west side, just Muslims everywhere.
The library on what's that?
Hey.
On his side of
I didn't know there was that many Muslims out west.
Right.
On the east side?
I didn't know there was any out there either.
Oh, neither.
You go to the east side's conquered. That's fucking. That's. Soon they gonna be busting out the
prayer. North got them all beat
up. North
got them all beat up.
Like, this bitch was like, she had the book. She put the book on the floor and she was just like,
right there.
She got up.
That goes totally against it. We might as well fucking switch gears and go into debt on these damn heathens.
Hey,
get that Matthew 6, because those Muslims, they pray five times a day. What the Bible says, pray in the closet. Because they pray because they won't be seen of men.
Gotta be seen.
Because that tell you that Islam shit ain't right there.
Right.
They blow a horn. And you're commanded to pray at a given time, five times a day. Because we pray continually all day in our minds.
All day. All day.
They be in front of that goddamn meteorite too, deep as hell, bowing down.
Right. That's why the Quran mentions the Israelites, but the Bible don't mention no Quran.
Right, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, ain't that something?
No, they'll try to say that the comforter was Muhammad.
Right.
It clearly says the spirit.
There's many scriptures on Israelites in the Quran.
Yeah, there is a lot of them.
Yep.
And there's scriptures in the Bible that says Ishmaelites are heathens. You know what I'm saying?
One of my friends.
Lord have mercy. See, the Lord, man, he like to play games with us. The Lord like to test us.
He'll give you a fine bitch, but that bitch be a nasty.
Yeah, she be nasty.
Yes, nasty.
Stinking.
The Most High, and she'll bring shit up on you, too. Like, she'll have some serious issues that really conflict with the scriptures, and the Most High is going to see if you still take it or not.
Yep.
Because sometimes you got to be like, no, bitch, I can't talk to you.
Fine bitch, you got a man.
Yeah, she might have a man, or she give you some... Or she just had a baby 8 months ago. She still got a newborn. Or, cause I was talking to some fine ass bitch, man. And she said that she had she had a baby. Wasn't even a year old yet. This bitch was trying to get with a dude. I'd never return her calls after that. You know what I'm saying? I ain't messing with you, man. Cause that's one that I ain't. I ain't taking care of nobody else's kids. I'm sorry.
Yeah, but that ain't no man's man. Ain't no man's man.
You see how the Lions do it? The Lions, when they got with the... With the Lions get with the new... With
oh, they killed the Cubs.
They kill all the Cubs.
It's a new sheriff.
They might just eat one of them, too.
Yeah, it might, yeah.
Just strangle the hell out of them.
They pretty much come in like there's a new sheriff in town.
So I don't want nothing to do with a bitch that got kids, man. That's just a major turnoff.
Because that's what it is.
But how many women you going to find as a virgin? But you can't even find a woman that has no kids, let alone a virgin.
Yeah, that's not the best.
6 years. Yeah, so it's hard, man.
6 years. That's not the best.
And then they look at you like you're crazy because you want to get a young woman as a virgin. They're like, oh, what, you a pedophile? Like, bitch, she's 16. She's fully grown. You see the rack on her? God damn.
See, that's the problem. That's the thing, these fucking devils, because, you know, what was it, 12? Back in the day, you know, you was a...
Well, it's still to this day in Vatican City, the legal age of marriage is 12. To this very day in the Vatican. Because they know.
That goes to show you too. You know, I mean, like, because in the ancient world, even them goddamn heathens had, like, children were smart. They had a lot of goddamn children ruling nations and shit.
Yep. There's still a lot of countries to this day. I mean, they don't even blink an eye at you getting with a young woman. They happy to get her out the house. Like, get your ass out. Yeah, Muslims.
Oh, yeah.
Because Muslims get some shit right, but they get most shit wrong.
I mean, it took it too far when he made that 9-year-old.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Unless she had it. Doubt that she had
No, you know, Muhammad is
a heathen.
Muhammad was a sick fuck, man. He was a sick, twisted, deranged motherfucker. Something went right with that guy.
I tell you, he comes from that Catholic shit. They promise the same thing.
Shit.
But even in the ancient world, like, you really ain't have Israel like men dealing with 10-year-olds and shit like that.
Oh, hell no.
They wait till they was young, like, you know, 17, 16.
What the scriptures say when they got to the flower of their age and they was fully mature, right, physically developed. Hey, they got a common saying over there, the Muslims in Afghanistan and other places, they say that little boys are for fun, but women are for children. That's how they get down.
Because that's even crazy. Then, like, even, like, you know, back in the day, if a father had a son and that little young lady, you know what I'm saying, the son will deal with it a little. I mean, that's the daughter's age, you know.
Hey, did somebody ever get that Matthew 5?
Okay.
Let's read that because we had quoted it. Let's bring it out.
Matthew.
This cuts that Islam shit because now that all this Islam shit is coming, that's what everyone's talking about right now. All of a sudden, now they're concerned with some goddamn Muslims. Even though it was the United States government that is giving all them heathens all those weapons, they giving them money to come over here.
I see. Yeah.
How do you think they came to America? The United States government is paying for those airline tickets to fly their asses over here. And when they come over here, they get free housing, an EBT card, they live tax-free.
So they work for the government.
They're pretty much government agents. That's all these heathens. They come up in our neighborhoods, set up businesses, leech off your community. That community. They leeching off your asses, taking all your money, fucking all your women, selling drugs, selling pork.
That's crazy.
And you people got no problems. Go ahead.
No problem.
Yeah. How come in the hood stores, how come it ain't people from that neighborhood that works in that store? It's a goddamn motherfucker, Abba Dubi Abba Muhammad, or some Sheik, or a Sheik, or an Elamite, an East Indian. Yeah, Abu. Is that, you know what I'm saying?
That's true.
Just taking all of our money. That's what they do. They're leeches. Yeah. They're parasites.
And then they send it back to their country.
Yeah. And if one of us had a store or something, the government would constantly breaking your balls.
Yeah.
The IRS, you'd be getting audited and everything under the sun.
You have to prove your money that you got. I just got something back from the IRS.
Oh, that goes.
Prove that when I filed my taxes, like, motherfucker, y'all know my background. Y'all could just type my shit in and see all that.
Know everything. Yeah.
And know everything. Yeah. Why the fuck I gotta verify my money that I work for?
It's with fucking you crazy, fuckers, man.
IRS is illegal anyway. Hey, bring that out.
It's fucked up.
Matthew 6 and 5. When thou prayest, thou shalt not be as the hypocrites are.
Listen, when you pray, do not be as the hypocrites. Keep going.
They love to pray standing in the synagogues and in the corners of the streets.
They love to pray in the churches, the synagogues, and the streets. Keep going.
That they may be seen of men.
That they may be seen of men. So that's what those goddamn Muslims do. Five times a day, they blow a horn. And they boo la 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 la. And everybody puts down their magic carpet and they start praying to goddamn Allah. Yeah, it is. That's some heathen shit. But that totally goes against what the scriptures teach. That's a cut to the churches too. You be up in them churches, they be like, everybody rise.
Right,
now
yeah,
let's
they sure
pray.
Do, don't they? Yep.
When the scriptures say pray in secret, keep going.
Good. They have their reward, but thou, when thou prayest, enter into thy closet, and when thou hast shut thy door, pray to thy Father which is in secret.
It is secret.
And thy Father which seeth in secret shall reward thee openly. But when ye pray, use not vain repetition, as the heathen do.
Yeah, vain repetition, as the who? As the heathen. As the Muslim. See, the word Muslim, that's just interchangeable with heathen. Because they using vain repetition. That's a heathen does that five times a day. What, you got to keep a rug on you?
Don't they say like Hail Marys? Like,
yeah, they do them Hail Marys. They do a Hail Mary for everything right. They do. And then they taking the shit, Hail Mary.
And then they go in the booth and confess their sins to a mere man.
Oh, you know why they do that too. The reason they set up those confessional booths and so the priest could he gets some dirt on everybody.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, anybody in their mind should know that you don't tell that priest shit.
Exactly.
You go in there, Father, I've sinned.
That nigga work for the feds.
You know what I'm saying? What did you do, my son?
He is. They do be narcs.
I mean, that's common sense right there. Common sense why they said, and if you don't go up to confession, they'll be like, we ain't seen you in there in a while.
Yeah, you know.
They probably story. In there jerking off to what you telling them and everything.
And you know they be going home and telling your story over the dinner table.
Yeah, they telling, because they're a bunch of faggots, child molesters.
Right.
So you gonna tell them your darkest secrets?
That's what I'm saying. It's a no fact. Everybody knows that shit, that they fuck children. Everybody knows.
But ever since that new pope came in, they put that to the side. They ain't talking about it.
That is true. But you know what else I noticed about this pope? He got a lot of FaceTime.
Yeah.
Than most of these other popes.
Yeah, because he's trying to pretend like he's the pope of the people, the common man. And the new pope even said, we got to accept homosexuals.
I can see that.
Wow. He said you got to accept divorced couples. Because before the Catholic Church would never tolerate divorce, right?
Yeah.
But now they're pushing it's okay to divorce. You can still, the divorce people can still take communion. You know, communion is off too. Ain't nowhere in the Bible said to go take communion every time you go to church. It's not in the scriptures. And the scriptures say, when they ate that bread and drank that wine, that's part of the Passover meal that happens once a year. Go ahead.
So they think that they shall be heard of their much speaking, but not ye therefore be not ye therefore like unto them. For your Father knoweth what things ye have need of before ye ask him.
Right, because the Most High, he already knows what we need. Because in them heathens, them Muslims think Allah, the non-existing one, is actually, if they pray enough, the non-existing one will answer them. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, the non-eternal one. It's an everlasting darkness.
After this manner, therefore, pray ye, our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Yeah, hallowed be the Lord. Yeah, hallowed be the Lord's name. Because, the Lord said this is how you pray. Keep going.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven.
And really, that's the prayer we say right now. We praying that the Lord's kingdom comes, so
for the Lord's kingdom to come, this kingdom's got to go. It's got to be destroyed.
Got to go.
And the kingdom of heaven cannot coexist with this shit. Oh, you be seeing people bumper stickers that say coexist. And they got the all the different cross mixed with the Star of David, right, mixed with the crescent moon. Nah, there ain't gonna be no coexisting.
They actually living in a fantasy land.
This is fantasy land.
Big ass billboard of innocent, what's the role?
Innis?
With the Quran saying that the Lord was a Muslim.
That's man.
Yeah, I seen that.
Yeah, it's right there. It's saying,
that should be burnt with fire.
But it's saying millions of people read the Quran. Mm-hmm. And it was like
that's what it says too.
It says something like,
ain't nobody reading that shit.
Why you think millions of people read it? They try to make it seem like it's the truth. Like, why is that? Yeah, that's what it says. Millions of people read the Quran.
But how come when you read the Bible, the Lord, he quoted Isaiah. He quoted Moses.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, that's
right. Muhammad wasn't even born yet.
That's right.
Didn't even exist.
Didn't even exist.
He was still swimming up in some heathen.
Yeah, he couldn't read.
Oh yeah, they didn't even tell you Muhammad was illiterate, so how stupid is he?
He was, you know how somebody sit at the table.
He's retarded.
Can't eat with forks, so he motherfucker eat with his hands.
Yeah.
He was foul.
Yeah,
he was
smelled.
A foul individual.
He was a true
you know?
Wild man in the desert.
Yeah, right, exactly, you know?
Yeah, he was a wild man. Just like his descendants today. You go to the Middle East now, that's just backwards as hell.
That's the spirit of the Lord gave
me. Motherfuckers eating camel meat. They probably having sex with the camels.
He was wild.
Camel pussy.
Yeah, because them Arabs, they just the foulest people.
Eating camel pussy.
Goat fuckers.
That's what they are, though. You know, well, actually, all them heathens, if it's a beast, man, they love them. If it's a heathen, they love beasts, man.
Yep.
You know, hey, keep quiet as kept. These Israelites, two-thirds of the Israelites like beasts, too.
Yep. You know? Our women, they be in there doing some weird shit with horses,
you know,
dogs.
You know, that's the spirit of Satan, man, on a motherfucker that's want to slay with a beast, man.
They got the donkey show down in Tijuana, Mexico.
You know who Aleister Crowley is, right? Aleister Crowley?
Oh, yeah.
Aleister Crowley, that's what these people are following after, man. That's what all these people are following after, yep. Aleister Crowley.
That's the
Aleister
spirit.
Crowley was known to fuck a woman and a beast at the same time to get them spirits.
Yeah, what he said,
chop the head off.
Yeah, he said he would let the goat fuck his girl, and while he ejaculated in his woman, at that very moment, he had sliced his neck, and he said he captured the spirit.
That's what they do. That's what they do, capture spirits. You know?
That's,
hey, this is the world we live in.
Oh, I know.
You know, in this world, America is ran by masonry.
Yep.
Masons, you know, devil worshippers. The whole, just the majority of America is masons.
Yep, from the judges to the teachers, the politicians, the sheriffs,
mm-hmm.
the principals of the schools.
Yeah.
They all devil worship.
Yeah, there's levels of that masonry, and these low-level masons don't know shit. They don't know shit.
Yeah, they don't know
some of them so stupid, they ain't allowed to advance.
Yeah.
Right, yeah.
You know, they ain't allowed to advance, so they just going along with the program, you know.
I just met a mason the other couple weeks ago.
That right there is a motherfucking child molestation.
Yeah, well, that's
from the Jew. Well, actually, no, Freemasonry, Albert Pike, you ever hear of Albert Pike? He said all Freemasonry is based on the Kabbalah, which is so-called Jewish mysticism. So, really, Masonry goes back to those so-called Jews.
Ain't that the guy that got the statue in Washington, D.C.?
Yeah.
Pike. Yeah, yeah.
He's the one who predicted World War III.
Right. Albert fucking Pike. Fucking demon.
Yeah.
Faggot. And a faggot.
Yeah, of course he had
hey,
to be a faggot.
Hey, man, you Irish?
Yeah.
Yeah. You're a brother, you know that, don't you? You know you're an Israelite, right?
No.
But let me tell you something, though. You're not Irish.
I'm Irish and German.
Well, yeah, that's
same
just a,
thing.
That's a confusing
that,
name, to,
that
just so you won't know who you are. You're an Israelite. Your nationality, you are an Israelite. You're not a white man. You're not Irish, like I said, Scottish or whatever, you know? You're an Israelite.
Cause you know the old, they used to call Ireland Hibernia, which goes back to the word Hebrew.
Daniel 7.
Hey, check it out, man. A lot of us don't even know we brothers, man. Just cause we look different.
Yep.
You understand what I'm saying? We brothers.
That's you know? The spirit. I was watching that video today.
That's why we cool, man. That's why we can, that's why we sit here and chat. We rapping with each other and we relating to each other. You understand? That's cause we brothers, man. We may not be brothers in the spirit, but we brothers. Yeah. You know,
I got scripture.
I believe that.
This is Daniel.
That's this goddamn world, man. That's looking at a motherfucker because he looked different. He, oh, he can't be my brother.
Yeah, that's, yeah. That's, you know, a carnal way to think.
Yeah, yeah.
Because, you know, in the ancient world, the people of the Most High got scattered amongst a whole bunch of other nations.
Yep.
I got a scripture. This is Daniel 9:7. O Lord, righteousness belongeth unto thee, but unto us confusion of faces.
Confusion of faces.
As at this day to the men of Judah and to the inhabitants of Jerusalem.
That's right.
And unto all Israel that are near and that are far off.
You know, all Israel.
Right, right. You know, when Paul was out up in Corinth, up in, when all through, you read Paul's writing, man, he's always bringing in them Gentiles. And them Gentiles, he's not talking about the Gentiles of the other nations. Those Gentiles are Israelites that's living amongst those other nations that's took on their customs, that's in all that heathenry shit, fucking animals, like in,
being homosexual.
You ever, you know about Pompeii in, up in near Italy? It was Israelites up in there, man. Fucking animals and shit.
You seen it?
Fucking animals and shit. But that was Paul bringing in the Gentiles that's in a Gentile state of mind. Now, when you read the Bible, the Bible speaks of not just one Gentile, it's two Gentiles. Gentiles of the other nations. And there's this Gentiles he's talking about that are our people that are living like those other nations. Eating pork, you know, worshiping the sun and the stars.
Yeah.
Worshiping, praying to them like these motherfuckers, like God.
Worshiping Satan, shit.
Right, right. You know, that's pretty much what the Babylonian, that's all that Babylonian bullshit that these people into, that Babylonian juice.
Hey, check this out. Matthew 15:24, where he kept talking about Israel, because contrary to popular belief, the Lord, the one they call Jesus, he came to save only the Israelites. Matthew 15:24. But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
Well, you read the Bible before, haven't you? That's why. You're an Israelite. That's why you were drawn to that book.
This is our
being
book.
In jail, they give you a Bible, that they give you something. Or your family, your mom or your dad might drop you a Bible off. Yeah. Why, if you got some time to do. You know? Because they Israelites. You know?
This is our book. This is the book
right.
of Israel.
You
that's
can,
right.
You can tell from the spirit, you know, because you got different type of people, so-called white or whatever, black, different spirits.
There's a lot of these white people are devils. They're